Welcome boys, in my virtual class, Rule SD, class of class 11. After coordinate and locus, we have already learned coordinate and locus. Today we start a new chapter, straight line. Coordinates are in the previous class, class 9 also, that is your revision. But straight line, not in previous class, obviously this is a new topic. So first we define what is straight line. Definition of straight line. I think definition of straight line not so easy. Most of the students learn straight line in class 6 or 5 and shortest distance between two points. Someone says shortest distance between two points is line segment, not line. Or ray, using ray, you may use this for, you may use this definition, okay. But if you use locus, then it is easy to define a straight line. Then it is very easy to define a straight line. How? In this way, if we take two fixed points, there are two fixed points and the locus of a point which moves in such a way that distance from two fixed points are always equal. Locus of a point in a plane, obviously, locus of a point in a plane which moves in such a way that distance from these two fixed points are always same. Then we get a straight line. How? Suppose this is a moving point. This distance is equal to that distance. Another one, this distance is equal to that distance. So if A and B are two fixed points, then the locus of a point which is equal distance from A and from B, then we get the locus is a straight line. This distance are equal. This distance are equal. Obviously, this distance is equal to that distance. So, if we use in this way, then definition of straight line is very easy. So what is the definition? A point moves in a plane in such a way that distance from two fixed points are always equal. Locus of a point which moves in such a way that distance from two fixed points on that plane is equal, then the locus is a straight line. If you use locus, then it is easy to define a straight line, obviously. So today we learn about different form of straight line and how we get the equation of straight line. Different forms also. First we define slope of a line, obviously. And every first degree equation, in x, y, two variable only, that is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means degree of x is 1 and degree of y is also 1 in this case. And abc here is constant, maybe it's parameter. Every first degree equation in two variable represent a straight line. Try to prove yourself first. Okay. My question is, every first degree equation in two variable represent a straight line. Okay. It is your classwork first. After that, we define slope of a line. What is the slope? Slope means, first we draw x-axis and this is y-axis. Obviously, this is positive direction of x-axis, this is negative direction of x-axis, this is positive direction of y-axis and this is positive negative direction of y-axis. This is x-dash, this is y-dash, this is known to all of you. Now, if a straight line makes an angle theta, suppose this one, this straight line makes an angle theta with the positive direction of x-axis. Then theta known as inclination. theta known as, this angle known as inclination. Inclination of the line. And tangent of the angle known as the slope. If a straight line makes an angle theta with positive direction of x-axis, then tangent of the angle which is denoted by m, slope, tan theta, slope or gradient, slope of a straight line is nothing but angle made by a line with positive variation of x-axis, then tangent of this angle known as slope or gradient. Obviously, theta taken as anti-clockwise direction, and theta must lie between 0 to pi by 2. Theta must lie between 0 to pi by 2, and theta taken as anti-clockwise direction, not in clockwise direction. It is a convention. So I repeat once again the slope. If a straight line makes an angle theta with the positive direction of x-axis, then the angle theta is called the inclination of the straight line, and tan theta, tangent of the angle theta, the tan theta, known as slope or gradient of the straight line. And conventionally it is taken as anti-clockwise direction, and theta always lies between 0 to pi by pi, 0 to pi. So obviously, when it is 0 and when it is pi, when gradient is positive and when gradient is negative, tangent of the angle tan theta is positive up to first quadrant. If theta lies in first quadrant, then tan theta is positive, it is known to you. And if theta lies in second quadrant, tan theta is negative, it is known to you. In which quadrant, which is positive and which is negative, all sine tan cos, this is known to you, all sine tan cos. Or in other area, all sine tan cos can be, remember in this way, add sugar to coffee. All sine tan cos. Add sugar to coffee. Without sugar, coffee is no taste. So add sugar to coffee, that means all sine tan cos. Okay, it is not our discussion today. Excuse me. Now, if the straight line is parallel to x-axis, then what happens? If the straight line is parallel to x-axis, this is x-axis and this line is parallel to x-axis, then angle with x-axis, how much? Angle of this line with x-axis, how much? Obviously 0 degree. So slope of this line is 0. Tan 0 is 0, we know that. Tan 0 is 0. Clear? So if a straight line parallel to x-axis, then its gradient is 0. And if a straight line parallel to y-axis, then what happens? This is x-axis, this is y-axis, parallel to y-axis, like that. So this angle is 90 degree. So value of tan 90 is, obviously, value of tan 90 is undefined. So slope of this line is undefined also. Slope of this line, when a line is perpendicular to x-axis, or in other words, if a line parallel to y-axis, then its slope is undefined, since tan 90 is undefined. Clear? Now, if a line makes angle theta in this way, I draw another figure. If you mind, keep it in your mind the figure, then it is easy to calculate. If this line is in this way, so this angle must be more than 90. This is positive direction of x-axis, obviously. So if the angle is more than 90 degree, then slope will be positive or negative. If the angle is more than 90 degree, then angle lies in second quadrant, obviously. I repeat once again, in second quadrant, tan theta is negative. So, if the slope is less than 90 degree, then slope is positive. If the angle is more than 90 degree, then slope is negative. Now, how we find the slope? How we find the slope of a line? If two points are given, then we have to find out the slope. How? Very easy. How many straight line can be drawn passes through two given points? One and only one. So if there are two points, one is AC, x1 y1 whose coordinate is x1 y1, and another point is B, say whose coordinate is x2 y2. This point is BC, this point is AC. Draw a perpendicular from A, say AM, and draw another perpendicular to x-axis from B. From B, we draw another perpendicular. Say this is M. AM and BM are two perpendicular. And from A, draw in perpendicular to BN also. Suppose this is AT. Now, from this, my drawing is not so correct. These two lines must be parallel to each other, obviously. This is parallel, we draw a perpendicular this. Now, these two lines are parallel. If this angle is theta, what about this angle? These two are corresponding angles, so it must be theta. This is also theta. This angle is also theta. So, what happens? Now, we have to find out tan theta. Now, from the triangle ATB, in triangle ATB, what happens? Tan theta is nothing but tan theta is equal to AT, sorry, BT by AT, perpendicular by base. From this triangle, BT by AT. Now, what is the value of BT? BN is Y2 and PN. TN and AM are same. TN and AM are same. AM, here we write OA is equal to X1, AM is equal to Y1, and ON is equal to Y2, ON is equal to Y2, and BN is equal to, sorry, this is X2, this is Y2. ON is X2 and BN is Y2. Now BT can be written as BT is equal to, you can write BN minus NT. Now BN, this is from the figure, BN is Y2. And NT is nothing but AM. These two are same, this is rectangle. TN and AM are same. What is the value of AM? Y1. So BT is Y2 minus Y1. Now AT, value of AT is nothing but AT and MN are same. This is AT, this is MN, these two are same. So MN can be written as ON minus OM. So ON is, from the figure, ON is X2. And this is OM is X1. So AT by BT, that is nothing but slope of the line is Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. This is the slope of the line. If two points are given, then the slope of the line is given by slope or M. That is, tan theta is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. That means, keep it in your mind, so then get a box. Slope is given by difference of ordinate by difference of abscissa. Okay, difference between the y coordinate my difference between x coordinate. This is we get, then we get the slope. So if you are using this formula, find the slope of a line passing through the points passing through the points, one is minus 6, 2, another is 5, 3. So slope of the line is using this formula, tan theta, that is the slope, m, y2, that means 3, minus 2, x2, that is 5, minus of, minus 6, that is 3 minus 2, that is 1, and 5 plus 6, that is 11. So slope is 1 by 11. And inclination is tan inverse 1 by 11. Tan inverse is 1 by 11. So slope is very easy to find. Very easy formula. Difference between y coordinate by difference between x coordinate. Then we get very easily the slope. So if two points are given, then we get the slope. Is it clear? Ordinate. Sometimes it is say slope is y by x. Slope is y by x. In that sense, y by x, that sense, the difference between y coordinate by difference between x coordinate, this is the slope. Next, we go to defined forms of a straight line. So, the general form of straight line, previously, I write ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, this is the general form of a straight line. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So, initially we see that there are three unknowns a, b, c for a particular straight line, but it is not three unknown. It is not three parameter. If a, b, c has changed, we get different straight line, x, y are variable. Excuse me. Firstly, we see that there are three parameters a, b, c. If a, b, c has changed, but if two conditions are given, then we get a particular straight line. How? We convert it into two parameters family, obviously. If we divide n by c, then we get a by cx plus b by cy plus 1. This is fixed constant 1. Now, a by c can be written as capital A and b by c can be written as capital B. That is equal to 0. So, if two conditions are given, only two, either in two points or one point slope or two intercept, etc. are given. If two conditions are given, then we find the particular straight line. Okay. If two points are given, then we find the particular straight line. How? First, two points form. First, we study about two points form of straight line. If two points are given, then we find the equation of the straight line. Two points are given. One point is say x1, y1, another point is say x2, y2. We have to find out the equation of the straight line. I write just formula or derivation. Which one is better? Derivation is better or just write the formula is better? Formula, first write formula. Very easy. Y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. This is the equation of the straight line. If two points are given, then we find the equation of the straight line in this way. Sometimes it's written in this way also. If we write this y minus y1 by y1 minus y2 is equal to x minus x1 by x1 minus x2. Both are same, just taking a minus common from the denominator of both sides, then we get this one. So, you may use this formula and find the equation of the straight line. Derivation is required or not? Yes or no? Most probably not, sir. Just if we know the formula, then we solve the problem. First, suppose we have to find out the equation of PQ. P is 2, 3 and Q is another point. 5, 6, 7. Find the equation of PQ using this formula. How? Just use this formula. Suppose this is x1, y1 instead of this and this is x2, y2. So, equation of the line y minus y1, that is y minus 3 by y2 is 6, 6 minus 3, y2 bar minus y1. And this is x minus x1. X1 means 2. And x2 means 5, 5 minus 2. So after simplification, we get y minus 3 by 3, that is equals to x minus 2 y 3. So 3, 3 cancel out, or x minus 2 minus y plus 3 is equal to 0. Take into right hand side. Then we can conclude this x minus y minus 2 plus 3, how much? Plus 1. This is the equation of the line x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0. X minus y plus 1 is equal to 0. This is 2 points for. Next we write slope point form. Slope point form. Two things are given. One is slope, another is point. One point. One point is given. Say point is given x1, y1. And slope is given, say slope is a. Point is given x1, y1, and slope of the line is given, say a is the slope. Then what is the equation of the straight line? If slope is given and one point is given, then how we find the equation of the straight line? If you use this, then very easy to calculate. This can be put in this form. Again we write this equation in another way also. Suppose this is y minus y1 is equal to, take into right hand side, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. This is present here, x2 minus x1. And this multiply x minus x1. Y2 minus y1 take into right hand side just. This take into right hand side by cross multiplication. Then what is this? Check it carefully. This is the slope of the line. That means if two points are given, then slope is m. So instead of this, we can write m instead of y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, we can write m. So that is equals to how much? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. This is the equation of the line. Equation of the line in slope point form. Slope is given and point is given. Then we can find the equation of the line. Very easy. For example, if we take, find the equation of the straight line which passes through the point, which is passes through the point, excuse me, 2, 3, and slope is 1. Passes through the point 2, 3, and slope is 1, we have to find out the equation of the straight line. We have to find out the equation of the straight line. How? Use this just y minus y1, y1 is 3 here. Slope m is given 1, x minus x1, x1 is nothing but this 2 only. So y minus 3 is equal to 1 into x minus 2. After simplification, or y minus 3 is equal to x minus 2, take into left hand side, or take into right hand side, x minus 2 minus y plus 3 is equal to 0, or it is written as, or x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0, like previous one. Same question, same answer. So x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0, previous one is this, since we take the point is 2, 3, and slope of this line is also, if we find the slope of these two line, these two points, find slope is also 1. How? Find if two points are given, the slope m is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. That is 6 minus 3, slope is, so So I repeat once again the formula, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, is it? So y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, that is it is 3 by 3, that is equals to 1. Clear? So obviously these two lines are same line. So if slope is given and point is given, then it is very easy to calculate. Now if the straight line given into general form, thus we have to find out the slope, how we get the slope. Next we go to the next topic. First we derive this. If a straight line given in this way, in general form straight line is given ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. If we write this by is equal to minus of ax minus c, ax and c taken to right hand side. Now suppose b is non-zero, obviously dividing by b on both sides. Suppose b is non-zero, obviously minus a by b x minus c by b, minus a by b x minus c by b. This minus a by b is the slope of the line. Is the slope of the line this one? Just coefficient of x, if we convert it into y is equal to mx plus c form, mx plus c form, then the coefficient of x is the slope of that line. Coefficient of x is that slope of that line. How? Now another form, this form obviously, slope point form. Next we find slope intercept form. Slope intercept form. This is slope intercept form obviously. Slope intercept form. That means slope is given. Intercept means, take care, y intercept is given. Intercept means, slope intercept means, if it is not given, otherwise we take intercept means y axis intercept only. So if a straight line this, either we first, then we have to draw the equation obviously. Suppose this is the line, slope is given, that means if the angle is theta, this is positive direction of x-axis, this is origin, this is y-axis, this is y-dash, in this direction x-dash. This angle theta given, that means tan theta is equal to m, is given, and y-axis intercept is given. Y-axis intercept is given means this length is suppose small c. This length is small c. Now if this length is small c, then what about this point? Coordinate of this point is any point on y-axis is in the form of 0 comma y-coordinate. X-coordinate is 0. So intercept of this line, this point, the coordinate is 0 c. Now we have already learned the slope is given and one point is given, then we very easily we find the equation of the straight line. How? The previous formula, just if we write slope intercept from the previous one, y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Point slope form, this is one point is given and slope is given. Then we write the previous question in y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. This is known to us now. So use this formula, slope is given, m, slope is m and point is 0 c, right here. Y minus c is equal to m into x minus 0, or it can be written as m into 0, this is m. So m into x, this c taken to right hand side, y is equal to mx plus c. This is known as slope intercept form. Slope intercept form. That means slope is m. Now if any straight line, just like previous one, any straight line is given, the previous last equation, x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0. Very easy. X minus y plus 1 is equal to 0. Convert into English way. Y is equal to, you can write x plus 1. So coefficient of x in this case is 1. The slope of the line is 1. Now if it is given 2x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0, find the slope of this line. If the question is find the slope of this line, then what happens? If we find the slope, then it can be written in this way: 3y is equal to 6 minus 2x, or y is equal to minus 2 by 3x plus 6 by 3. After simplifying, we get y is equal to minus 2 by 3x plus 2. Now the coefficient of x is minus 2 by 3. So slope of this line is, so is equal to how much? Minus 2 by 3. If the question is this straight line makes an angle with positive direction of x-axis acute or obtuse, this line makes an angle acute or obtuse with positive direction of x-axis. Obviously slope is negative. If slope is negative, then it must be obtuse angle. That means angle made by the line and positive and x-axis, obviously positive direction of x-axis is, it is negative, then it is more than 90. That means obtuse angle. This straight line must make an angle obtuse with the direction of x-axis. Similar for this, it is 1. This line slope is 1. 1 means makes an angle, standard angle obviously. What is the value of how much? What is the 1? 10, 45 degree. So the angle made by the line, this line, angle made by this line is 45 degree with positive direction of x-axis. Must be acute also. And this is the special case, this one. So we know slope intercept form also. I told only one form today, another one, already 33 minutes gone. So only intercept form. Up to this, today's topic, up to intercept form, only intercept form. Intercept means x-axis intercept as well as y-axis intercept. X-axis intercept and y-axis intercept are given. Then we have to find out the equation of the line OX, say YZ. If a line cuts x-axis at A and cuts y-axis at B, and coordinate of A is, say, this length is, x-axis intercept is small a, and y-axis intercept is, say, small b. This length is small b and this length is small a, it is given. That means the coordinate of A is how much? If this length is A, then the coordinate of A is x-axis, that means a0, and coordinate of B is 0b. So using this 2 points form, y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. I repeat once again, 2 points form this is. So put there y minus y1. Suppose this is y1 is 0. y2 is b minus y1. Again this is 0. X minus x1. x1 is a. x2 means 0 by x1, that is a, or this is y by b is equal to x by minus a, and this is minus a by minus a, so it is a by a, both are negative, so minus minus plus also. Take this one into left hand side, x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. This is the intercept form of straight line. x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. This is intercept form of straight line. If a straight line is given, say 3x plus 4y minus 12 is equal to 0, if the question is find the y-axis intercept and x-axis intercept, if we convert it into intercept form, then very easy to calculate the x-axis intercept or y-axis intercept. Or otherwise, you can find also, if we put x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0 separately, then you get that this length of xt. Now convert into the standard form, that means intercept form. How? If we take this is 3x plus 4y is equal to 12, it is given, the coefficient is plus 1, so we divide both sides by 12, x by 4 plus y by 3 is equal to 1. This is the standard form, that means intercept form. So y x-axis intercept, x-axis intercept is 4 unit, and the y-axis intercept is 3 unit. Okay, and the coordinates at which cuts x-axis from this one, we can write this is 4, 0, and the coordinate on y-axis is 0, 3. This is the intercept form. From intercept form, we can very easily find this. Okay. That's enough for today. The video length is done. Next day, in next class, we discuss few problems obviously. And the other form, that is, two forms are remaining. One is normal form and other is symmetrical form. And obviously, revise this one, the formula. Okay. Today, up to this, next I give you some problem, try yourself, and very easy problem obviously. I think all of you solve this problem. Okay. Thank you.